Hello, this is Ben, and over the years I've made a lot of money from cold emailing, and the key to that success I think has always been having the right systems in place, systems that optimise your deliverability, cut down any unnecessary costs and just improve overall efficiency. And if you're a new business owner or young or inexperienced, someone who's trying to scale their business, cold emailing is an incredible tool to be able to do that, if it's done right. And the likelihood is that I've probably been in your shoes. I was new to it. I was young. I was inexperienced. I didn't have any money and I certainly didn't have it all figured out. So I created this system for myself, which once the domain's bought, it sets up absolutely everything. The DNS records, the email addresses. It then adds it to a Google Sheet ready to add into my favorite email sending tool, which was and still is instantly.ai. So yeah, this system's something that is fully optimized to get you good results whilst not breaking the bank. So without further ado, I never promised you it was simple. Right, so all I'm going to do is here is talk you through it. I'll put the blueprint in the description so you guys can have it. But I'll just talk you through and give you a bit of context to how this works and give my two pence on cold emailing and what you should really be doing for optimizable results. So I use Namecheap to get my domains. So I go into here, I search for a domain and I'll just buy it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, however many I need. Then what this does, this gets the domains that I've just bought, iterates over them, and here's a filter. So if the date and time they were created from the iterator is later than or equal to now, today, those are the only ones that will pass. So, you know, it's not going to pass ones that you bought 2 days ago. It's only going to process new domains. Then I use an email sending provider called SparkPost, just to show you what they're like. They're an email sending tool mainly for marketing emails, not really optimized for cold emails. I use them personally still now for, and I use a dedicated IP because I just can't trust the likes of Instantly, Mailforge and those software companies where you buy and set up your own mailboxes for a fraction of the price of Gmail. So I thought, right, I'm going to take matters into my own hands. So I went and bought a dedicated IP. That's about £60 per month. But what you can do is just use their shared IPs, which is still pretty good. For $20 a month, you get 50,000 emails, which is good enough. So at the moment, we're at $20 per month, which is about 15, 16 quid. So I add the domain in there and I add the bounce domain in there. So that's just an extra layer of protection for deliverability issues. That then gets passed and we set the variables. So the HTTP requests here give us the DKIM and we need to get the SLD and the TLD. So here we just get the DKIM and the selector, which I'll show you later. This gets the SLD, so the first bit of domain before the dot, and this gets the last bit, so .com, .co.uk, .biz, .ai, .io. This goes into Namecheap and sets up the DNS records. It sets up the DKIM, and at the moment that's all we've set up. And I've set up the SparkPost sending the CNAME and the TXT. So that automatically gets set up in Namecheap on my advanced DNS. I then basically save these in a variable, the DKIM, the CNAME and the TXT record as a variable. We add that domain to the IP pool. Then I used a software called ImproVMX. These for $9 a month, so about 7 quid. So we're at, about £22 per month at the moment. You can set up 30 domains, 100 aliases per domain, but obviously you only want to be setting up 3 to 5 for cold emailing. You don't want to go over that per domain. And you can just set up aliases. So how it works is you'll add the domain and then you'll just set up the aliases. So ben.yul, andrew.tate, donald.trump. And you can set up your own aliases that forward to your main address. So whenever you receive a reply from your cold email, it will forward into your main address and you can just say, oh, Donald Trump's off sick today, so I'm taking over. His emails are getting forward to me and I'm taking over, or whatever you want to say. So that adds it into there and creates the aliases. So I think here I've got Ben.Yo, Jack.Jones, Amelia.Take. Then we sleep just so it can, the DNS records can get updated and whatnot. And we'll delete the star alias because for some reason ImproVMX always just comes with it with a star alias. So you want to get rid of that. Then you want to get the existing records of that domain. Then we are getting the details of the domain in ImproVMX, setting the variables of them, the MX records and everything, and the SPF value for the sending SMTP server for SparkPost. Then we'll do our final update of the whole DNS records that need going into that domain. We'll wait a little bit, a minute, before then verifying. We'll verify the domains, we'll verify the bounce domain, iterate, set them as variables. So the first name, the alias, is getting split. So that basically just capitalizes the first name and capitalizes the second name, and then gets added into a Google Sheet ready to put into instantly. I will show you this because you're going to need, you've got the SMTP in SparkPost. You're going to need an IMAP provider. SMTP sends the emails out. IMAP receives those emails in, allows your inbox to receive emails. So I chose Zoho Mail, a free account, and I just used one account. So this one account will take in the receiving email to that one account, and these will send it all out. If hopefully that makes sense. Now, I wonder if I can show you how it's looked before. No, I can't. No. Okay, well, that's pretty much it. I hope that made sense. I probably just rushed through it more than I have, but there's not a lot to go over. And like I say, it is complicated, but this just sets everything up for you automatically. For an overview, you buy a domain from Namecheap, you run this, and it will add that domain to SparkPost, which I believe will give you DKIM, SPF, and TXT records, as well as CNAME record to set up. It will then update that in Namecheap. We'll then add that domain to ImproVMX, which will then set up the aliases, the email accounts that you want to create. These are, just think of these as virtual mailboxes. They aren't physical, they're just virtual. Then we'll update the DNS records for the final time. We'll verify it, make sure that everything's okay, and then we'll add it into a Google Sheet. And they can quite easily get added into instantly. It still works. I just warm them up for as long as you can, 3 to 4 weeks. And I'd just be mindful of the fact that you are using one IMAP here. You are, even though it's doable, it's not fully optimized for the best results. But like I say, this is just a completely budget, low cost cold emailing system that sets up everything for you. You don't have to set it up yourself. So it sets it up within one click of a button. And I think we said, what, £22 per month, plus then instantly. I'm not 100% sure how much instantly is. But it's a low-cost way. My deliverability was never absolutely shocking. I still managed to scale my business with this system. And I'm hoping you can too. So like I said, I hope that that explains everything. I'm going to put this blueprint in the description, so it's yours to have. You can tweak it, modify it, optimize it if you think there's a better way of doing it. But yeah, essentially buy your domains from Namecheap. It'll set them up in SparkPost, which is where you're going to be sending your emails from. Then it's going to set up your email addresses. And then it's going to do the final update of your DNS records. Make sure they're all verified. Add them to a Google Sheet ready to upload. And I'll actually show you what the Google Sheet looks like. Now, sorry guys, I wasn't able to find what the spreadsheet looks like because it's been a long time since I've used this system. In my next video, I'll show you the system that I actually use now, which is quite similar. It's a tiny bit more manual work, but it's a little bit more expensive as well, but it's certainly worth it. I'll show you that in the next video. But if you guys like this, then give it a like, a comment, a subscribe. This was probably crap again, but just let me know. I'll see what I can do to make my videos a bit better. But yeah, no, thanks for watching. Hope this works for you if you're young and new and trying to start out. But other than that, take care.